There was a vote today in the city council to require the administration to announce a comprehensive plan to vaccinate homebound senior citizens for COVID.
And that will likely be welcome news for one local family now trying to get the vaccine to their ailing mother. CBS 2's Vanessa Murdoch has the story.
Right. The Letty sisters of Washington Heights called CBS 2 News out of love and devotion to their mom.
She worked midnights always so that she could take care of us.
Gladys Letty cared for her grandkids too, loved to dance. Then Alzheimer's robbed her of mobility. She hasn't walked since 2013.
This is mommy's room.
Gladys, now 87 years old, has diabetes, is non-communicative and homebound. Deborah and Doris tell us they're doing everything possible to get their mom a COVID vaccine at home. They called CBS 2 News to shed light on their struggle.
If people can get it in a nursing home, why isn't the homebound people getting it? Because they are vulnerable.
The sisters started asking persistent questions of the visiting nurse service in January. No answers. Contacted the Department of Health. The response here.
Everything was about bringing my mom to a location. Nothing about bringing somebody to my house.
She can't go out. It's too much of a big deal and it's too high of a risk.
During a press conference Tuesday, city officials shared planning continues for vaccination of homebound seniors.
In-home vaccination of folks who cannot leave their home. That really requires a Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
Wednesday, the FDA released data from the phase 3 clinical trial. An authorization for emergency usage could come as soon as Saturday. In the meantime, the city expands its mobile fleet.
We have to join that existing infrastructure with what we learn about the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
Unknowns right now, storage and handling requirements.
But once we bring those two halves together, we will be ready to very rapidly do the door-to-door or in-home vaccination. We hope in March, if everything goes according to plan with the FDA.
It should be happening already.
Deborah says with rollout starting in March, there's no telling when her mom will actually receive the vaccination. From Washington Heights, Vanessa Murdoch, CBS 2 News.